Hello and welcome to the Diverse Node tutorials for Reflow 10. Reflow's innovative GPU-powered Diverse Solver lets you simulate materials like sand or soil, but also snow in different flavors from dry to wet. In three video lessons, I'm going to show you how to adjust Diverse's granular parameters and work with our new solver. In this first lesson, we're going to start with a very basic scene, and you probably know this setup from various videos. I've added two collision objects for the particles, as well as a gravity daemon, and the ground cube is just hidden here. Both cubes have a rather high die friction value to prevent the particles from moving away too far. Let's also take a quick look at the Diverse square emitter. The only change is that the emitter does not create a constant stream of particles, but a volume instead. The domain is much more interesting because this is a place where the snow's properties are located. So just change the particle type to granular. But before we dig into the individual parameters, we will make one more adjustment. Simulation substeps and iterations have a strong influence on Diverso, and with the default settings, it is likely that we are not able to achieve the typical look of snow. So open Reflow simulation settings next to the Simulate button and go to the Diverso tab. To get a better understanding of these parameters, I recommend our Reflow blog. The entry Iterations in Diverso tells you in detail how substeps and iterations influence the simulations. There are also several videos showing the effect of different settings. The values shown here are our basic settings for the upcoming simulations. And you should not miss to ignite Diverso Superboost, because with a good GPU, you will be able to accelerate your simulations by 4 times or even more. But let's go back to the domain. These pre-adjusted values are the result of several tests, and you can take them as a starting point for your own projects. In the following comparisons, we will examine the influence of the individual parameters on our basic snow scene. As you can see, there are two forms of friction: friction and static friction. If you try to slide two objects past each other, you need a certain amount of force to trigger a motion. And if the force of friction is greater than the applied force, nothing will happen. This is static friction. It is like a limit you have to overcome to create a motion. If you add more force, the object breaks free and starts to slide. But you still need to apply a certain amount of force to keep the object sliding. And what's acting here is called kinetic friction, or just friction. And you will not need as much force to keep the object moving as you need to push a motionless object. This means that friction should be smaller than, or at least equal to, static friction. With friction set to 0.1, the particles will continue to slide, but the relatively high static friction keeps everything together. But what can we expect when static friction is set to 0.1 as well? In this case, the particles break free much easier and the material gets more powdery. With both parameters set to 1, the particles try to keep their shape as long as possible, and only gravity rips the snow apart. Our next parameter is cohesion, and this is what creates the snow's clumpy and wet appearance. Before we continue, here's again the simulation with our initial settings. As you can see, chunks and pieces break loose from the main body of snow and pile up. But in simulations with cohesion set to 0, the particles hardly have any connection and tend to fly apart. Later they trickle like salt or sugar. With a cohesion of 0.9, the material appears to be more watery again. And there is indeed a limit of around 0.7 for the creation of chunks, and higher settings might destroy this effect. Roughness mimics the circumstance that sand or snow particles have different shapes, edges, and spikes. With higher settings, we observe an increasing repulsion effect. A value of 0.3 still gives good results here, but with 0.6, we see a lot of pieces flying around, as shown in the next clip. Roughness is very sensitive and should be increased in moderate steps like 0.05. Then we also have stacking. With this parameter, we are able to control the formation of piles. In this clip, stacking is 0 and the simulation now appears like heavy snow with a high amount of water. With 0.9 on the other hand, we get much higher piles, but the snow also looks more grainy and we can observe a flicker effect in the particles' velocities. Finally, there is damping. Damping adds viscosity to the material and it helps to improve the overall behavior. Without damping, we get a more splashy impression and the particles start to flow apart. A value of 2 keeps the snow together and this simulation looks less vivid. So, damping can help to tame misbehaving particles and achieve a smoother look, but it's certainly not a universal remedy for all of your problems. And maybe you've also recognized that all testing parameters range between 0 and 1 except damping. Although the parameters accept any positive value, it is a good idea to stay within this range in most cases. Okay, now we have a good idea of how diverse as granular particles behave, and our snow settings are a nice starting point for the next projects. For now, thanks for your attention and have fun with ReFlow 10.